Happiness, happiness is mine. Happiness is mine.
I told old Satan
to get thee behind.
You know that.
Peace, 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 peace is mine. Peace, peace is mine.
I told old Satan to get thee behind.
You know that.
Love, 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 love is mine.
Love, love is mine.
Love is mine.
I told old Satan to get thee behind.
You know that.
In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus,
that mighty name of Jesus,
you know that.
Who can stand when we call?
His name is
Jesus. We have
In the name of Jesus, the mighty name of Jesus,
you know that we have.
In the name of Jesus,
the mighty name of Jesus,
you know that.
Who can stand when we call?
Jesus, the master's name of Jesus.
You know that we have a victory.
In the name of Jesus, the mighty name of Jesus.
Who can stand when we call?
In the name of Jesus,
the mighty name of Jesus,
the powerful name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus,
the master's name of Jesus.
You know that.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
In the name of Jesus, we have the victory.
Hallelujah. No matter what you might be going through today, hallelujah. If you want victory, you can find it in Jesus. We have come into this place gather in his name to worship and to honor and to reverence God. That's the reason we're here. If you come for any other reason, you're in the wrong place. Hallelujah. But whatever you have in your heart today, whatever you need to be fixed, if you need something fixed today, Jesus can fix it. Whatever it is, if Jesus don't have it, he can make it for you. Hallelujah. So I ask you to relax, sit back, and don't get too comfortable. Whatever the Lord will have you to do today, do it. In the name of Jesus. Because all our victories are in him. For we have gathered here today to worship and to give honor and to praise unto the one that died on the cross that we might have the right to a tree of life. Let us pray. Most holy and everlasting Father, we have come today, Lord, to seek you, dear God, the one that is able to save unto the uttermost. Father, we bless you this morning, dear God, for you allowed us, Lord, to be able to rise this morning to a new day. And Lord, we consider this is a new start on today, dear God, because every day has its own problem. Yesterday had its problem. Today have its problem. And tomorrow we're going to have its problem. So today, Lord, we're going to render to you what we have on our heart today, dear God. Things that we could not fix. Things that we've been struggling with, dear God. We're going to lay it all at the foot of the cross today, dear God. Lord, we don't want to leave today like we came in. Because, Lord, we all stand in the need of something today. Oh, Father, we bless you, we praise you, and we give you all the honor and all the glory. Thank you, dear God, for these your people that you have sent this way this day. Whatever they need may be, granted to them, Father, in the mighty name of Jesus that we pray. Amen. At this time, I ask you to stand, please, and on the back of your program, we will do a congregation here. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. At the back of your pew, your hymn books, page 220. Amen. I'm if you turn to the back of your program for our mission statement. I will read the mission, you read the vision. We'll read the vision together, and the Great Commission read all together. Then Jesus came and spoke to them, saying, "All authority has been given to me in heaven and on earth. Go therefore and make disciples of all nations. Baptize them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Teach them to observe all things I have commanded you. And remember, I am with you always, even to the end of ages." Amen. The vision.
Yes. To empower others in this community and abroad. We shall be recognized as the chosen people of God that will operate as created and not to fail, the luminary and not the barber, and ultimately the royal priest and ambassador of Christ that God has placed in the church to reflect his glory. In order to fulfill the Great Commission
and the vision that is
before us,
we will intentionally try to die to our will daily in order that the will of God may be done.
We will meditate on God's word, pray without ceasing, and show unconditional love, which will empower us to reach others and share the light and the love of Jesus Christ wherever the Holy Spirit leads.
Amen. Praise the Lord. Now we have prayer by Claude Davis.
Good morning, church. Let us bow out here. Our Father, which art in heaven, Lord, we thank you for another blessed day. This is the day that you have made and for us to be joy and be glad in it. Father God, we thank you for waking us up this morning. We thank you for touching our bodies this morning. We was able to get up and put on our clothes and come out to the house of the Lord. Father God, we left all the baggage on the outside. We come right now just to give you all the praise and all the honor. Because you have been so good to us, Lord. Oh God, we thank you right now. Father God, we pray for the sickness right now. We ask you that you touch them with that healing hand that you have, Lord. Oh God, Heavenly Father, we ask you to touch the service this morning, Lord. We ask you to touch them and have your way, oh God. Father God, we ask you that you just touch the young choir. Help them the same in me. Just have your way with them. Lord, we ask you to touch the usher, touch the members of the church, the guests.
Yes.
Most of all, Lord, we ask you to touch our pastor. We ask you that you just equip him with the word that somebody may holler, "What shall I do to be saved?" Oh, Father God, we ask you to come into the house and have your way, Lord. Oh, God, Heavenly Father, somebody needs you right now, Lord.
Yes.
Oh, God, he's been so good to us, Lord. Forgive us for our sin that we have fell short each and every day. But, Lord, you look beyond our faults and saw our need. Oh, God, Heavenly Father, you've been good. Oh, God, we just thank you right now, Lord. And, Lord, we ask you right now if there's anything that we haven't done or we haven't said, we ask you to fix it for us right now, Lord, that we will represent you, Lord. Oh, God, Heavenly Father, we thank you for the travel mercy that we have came to your house, Lord. We ask you to bless those that couldn't come. We ask you to bless the sickness that our sick list, Lord. We ask you to bless each and every one of them right now, Lord. And, Lord, as we pray and ask you to forgive us and give us and bless our day, Lord. Bless you throughout the next week, Lord. We give you the honor and the praise in Jesus' name. Amen.
be seated.
Together for our Starlight Sons today. Amen. They are traveling with me to First Baptist in Hollow Springs today. This will be their first outing with me. Amen. Don't they look good? They got their massages and everything on. Amen. To God be the glory for the great things that He has done. We want to welcome our visitors and guests on today for coming to worship with us. Amen. At New Bethel, you could have went some of anywhere, but you chose to stop by New Bethel. And to help us lift up the name of Jesus, each and every one of you are very special, but I do want to give a shout-out to Beta, Lambda, Sigma, Philos of Sigma, amen. Gamma, Rho, Sorority, amen. Amen. They're on our second and third pews. I got some family in there, some cousins and friends and an old school teacher that said, I can't believe that boy preaching. Miss Wall. Amen. She used to wake me up in class. Amen. Was that 11th or 12th grade? I don't even remember what grade it was. But I made it, didn't I? He made it! Somehow I made it. God be glorified. But we welcome all of our guests and visitors on today, and we pray that New Bethel might say something, sing something, do something, show some type of act of kindness that will cause you to want to leave this place and say, I had church on today. In Jesus' name, amen. Our scripture for the morning is located in your bulletin. If you would be so kind to pull that out, we believe that we stand on the word of God. If you are able to stand, please feel free to stand as we prepare to read our morning text responsively. I will begin, and you will follow. I need you to read it like you mean it. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. We believe in making a joyful noise as we read the word of God. You have set your glory above the heavens. Out of the mouth of babes and nursing infants, you have ordained strength because of your enemies to silence the enemy and the avenger. Together, when I consider your heavens, the work of your fingers, the moon and the stars which you have established, what is man that you are mindful of him? And the Son of Man, that you attend to him. For you have made him a little lower than the angels, and crowned him with glory and honor. You have given him dominion over the works of your hands. You have put all things under his feet. Together, all sheep and oxen, and also the beasts of the field, the birds of the air, and the fish of the sea, and whatever travels the paths of the seas. O Lord, our Lord, how excellent is your name in all the earth. Amen. Just before you sit down, I want to speak with you from the subject dominion. We began to talk about dominion on last Sunday, and we want to continue in that, the dominion that God has given us. With the subtopic, I don't know about you, but I can't live without him. God, we thank you again for this opportunity to worship you in spirit and in truth. We thank you, God, for the worshipers, some broken, some seeking, some don't know what to do, some don't know where to go. But God, we recall in your word how you came that we might have life and have it more abundantly. And then, Jesus, I like what you said when you said you didn't come to condemn the world, but you came to set us free, God. You came, God, to bring us out of the darkness into your marvelous light. So, God, a few of us just want to say thank you, God. We recall how you healed 10 lepers, but one came back to say thank you. God, let New Bethel be the one to say thank you, for you have done great things. And now I pray, God, that again, as I always say, that you would demote me to absolutely nothing. Let me be like a glove that you can literally slide your hands into. Let me be like a shoe, God, that you can slide your feet into, God, and show your loving kindness. Let me be your prophet for the moment, your spokesperson, your ambassador, your priest that's available for you, God. And now I pray, God, that after all is said and done, that someone might come down this red carpet, not looking for a Grammy, not looking for an Oscar, not looking for a trophy, but looking for your crown of righteousness. Someone here isn't saved on today. And God, everything that New Bethel has done all week long has been for this moment. Someone is dealing with a hardship on today. Someone's marriage is not what you would have it to be. Someone's children has gone astray. Someone is dealing with pain in the body. Someone has gotten a doctor's report that they don't like, God. Someone is dealing with chemo. Someone is dealing with dialysis. Someone is dealing with high blood, low blood. Someone is dealing with something, God. But God, let them know that you're in the house. and that you are able to do exceedingly above what we can think or imagine. And all they need to do is come, just like they are. Now, God, move pride. God, we come up against the works of the enemy. We come up against everything, God, that will keep us in our seats. God, some are watching us by way of live streaming. Maybe they're in their living room, their bedroom. I don't know where they are. Maybe they're on their cell phone, God. But I pray that same word that is resonating in these hearts will resonate in their heart. And now I pray that the words of my mouth and the meditation of my heart will be acceptable in your sight. For you are my strength and my redeemer. In Jesus' name, somebody shout amen. 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 Put your hands together as the choir come and bless us in song again. Amen. Amen. Hosanna. Amen. Amen. Talking about dominion on today, as I had mentioned earlier, we dealt with dominion on last week because we here in New Bethel understand the grave importance of us remembering and recalling that because of what Jesus Christ did for us on Calvary, we're able to get back the dominion that we lost in the garden. Amen. Remember, we lost our dominion in the garden because we saw that the fruit was good and it tasted good. And then we tried to cover ourselves with fig leaves and Jesus came looking for us. And we went farther in the woods, Reverend Davis, trying to hide from God. Have you ever tried to hide from God? I knew y'all were going to say amen. Oh, yeah. Long story short, we lose our dominion, we lose our authority, we lose our power, we lose our, to some degree, our relationship, our right relationship with God, and now we're trying to find our way back to the dominion, the power, and to become the priest, the royalty, amen, the representatives of who God has called us to be. So by way of what Jesus did on Calvary, amen, he became our bridge over troubled waters, amen. Dealing with dominion again on today, David, who was a shepherd boy, now he is a king. He is writing this song of nature, this song of creation, this song of wisdom. It has many descriptions, but he is writing because God has done something great in his life. In Psalms 6 and Psalm 7, he says, "O Lord, do not rebuke me, O Lord, where you are." But here in Psalm 8, he says, "O Lord." Miss Wall, O is an interjection, by the way. She was my English teacher. I know you thought I won't sleep in all the time. I had to look this one up, though. But he is interjecting that God has done something that's marvelous. He is injecting, the shepherd boy is injecting that God has done something on his behalf. It's a personal thing that's wonderful. And by him simply saying, "Oh," what he's saying is like, "I don't have the words to tell you what God has done in my life." Come on, somebody. You know, there's really nothing in Webster, nothing in the dictionary that can describe what God has done for me. See, there was a time when David was always on the run from his enemies. There was a time where he was even on the run from his very own son, Absalom, remember? You know, sometimes your own very own family will put you on the run. Oh, come on, y'all. Come on. It's okay. It's okay. Don't act like everything good and nice at home. Come on. You got children. Then give your Mother's Day call. Y'all better act like you know. They don't call till they need some. I got children. David is in awe. So we see the theology of God. It opens up with the theology of God, the study of God, and it goes to anthropology. It's the study of man and the Christology, the study of Christ. We see all these, even zoology is in here. I just say that because we got some seminary students in here. They want to hear some big words. So I'm done with them. Now let's get to the main line of what God is trying to say. He is expressing his joy. And it's as though he wasn't even expecting God to do this. God, I thought I had to go through the scalpel and the blade for the cancer to be removed. But I went back to the doctor, and the MRI, the CAT scan, it's not even there anymore. You know, sometimes, I ain't going to tell it since she's in here, but somebody told me that they had 24 hours before their lights was about to be cut out. Just on Wednesday, Bible study students, y'all remember that? And she said that that she didn't have a dime in her pocket. But she went to the mailbox. Have you ever been standing in the need of a financial blessing and you went to the mailbox? Or you just checked your account? Hey, look, he's just saying the check is in the mail. That's all he's saying. Look, he's saying don't even worry about that. Don't even worry about the bill. Don't get caught up in the doctor's report. Don't even get caught up in who walked out on you. I have something bigger and better for your life. If you're going to get caught up on this is the day that the Lord has made. I shall rejoice. If we're going to get caught up in something, let's get caught up in Jesus. Amen. He says, Oh Lord, how excellent is your name in all the earth. Lord, your name is excellent. Your name is majestic. God, your name is all of the, I can't even describe your name. Look, he's just talking about the name. He hasn't even gotten to what God has done because something happens at the name of Jesus. My Bible says every knee shall bow and every tongue shall. You know, you can just call on his name and things begin to change. That's the power of the name of Jesus. He begins to tell him your name is excellent. He said, you who have set your glory above the heavens. In other words, God, you set your glory above all of the galaxies. You set your glory above the planets, the moons, and the stars. You set your glory so high the shuttle can't get to it. No astronaut, no lens, no telescope has been developed right now that can see what you've set. It's so high, God. And for you to set it there, you must be a mighty strong God. Is that all right? See, we serve a strong God. See, he's a powerful God. He's the great I am. And if he can set glory above all of this, why can't he pick you up? Come on, what you going through? What did the doctor say? He's strong enough to do exceedingly, abundantly, above what you can think or imagine. Look, whatever you're thinking about, he already worked that out. He's above that. He's bigger than that. He's great. Said you set your glory above the heavens and the earth, Deacon Edson. And then he begins to talk about babes and sucklings and infants and children when they come out of the womb. Do Bethel, y'all have to hear it again from 8 o'clock, and you've heard it before. How a baby, when a baby comes out of the mother's womb, he starts crying. And if the baby isn't crying, he gets spanked because the doctors want to make sure that the baby is breathing. I wonder if sometimes God begin to spank us because we ain't saying nothing. And he want to make sure everything is all right. Because some of us don't begin to cry out until we're going through some. And the elders, like God said, oh, I just wanted to hear from you. That's all. I was going to work it out. I just, see, somebody was going through something right now. And he said, look, I just needed to hear from you. Because when a baby is crying, somebody's going to see about that baby. As a matter of fact, one start crying out on the day, y'all do something. Y'all see about that baby. Yeah. You know, I believe that's why God even gave infants and babies the lungs that he gave them. Why? Because that's the only way that the baby can let you know that something ain't right. I'm hungry. I'm wet. I'm sleepy. Some of us just fall. But I wonder what would happen if we just begin to cry out and say, I need thee, oh God, I need thee every minute of the day. God, I need you. Somebody said, I can't even walk without him holding my hand. See, some of y'all got it together because y'all educated, and some of us making six figures, and some of us are doing well, and your marriage is good, and your children, all of them got their master's degree, and you're debt-free. Everything is good. But for my brothers and sisters going through like me, every now and then I just like to cry out. I just like for them to hear my voice. even when times are good, I just like to just cry and say, God, I thank you for another day. God, I thank you that all is well. God, I may not have money, but I thank you for waking me up another day. So, this morning we talked about alarm system for those of you that have those mansions and those alarm systems to go with them. You know how you set your alarm system. The reason you set your alarm system is because you don't want any intruders, any thieves and robbers to come and break in your home. So you have an alarm system so that when someone come in your home and you're not there, perhaps you're even there, the system goes off and there's a loud noise that's supposed to deter the enemy or deter the intruder from breaking into your house. Are y'all there with me? And see, when he hears the alarm system goes off, he begins to flee because he knows that help is on the way. I don't got no help. I ain't got no help. See, when it goes bam, 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 see, he begins to flee and leave you alone. See, the Bible says that he have ordained, predestined, predetermined praise from babes and sucklings that it may silence the avenger and the enemy. See, the reason the devil is still messing with some of us the reason they say ain't going nowhere because some of us are too proud for the crowd and say, God, I need you. But David said, I will bless the Lord at all times. Watch this. When my bills are not due, I'm going to bless the Lord. Look. When the doctor's report is good, I'm going to bless the Lord. If the doctor's report is bad, I'm going to bless the Lord. If my children's financial aid gets taken care of or not, I'm going to bless the Lord. I wish I had some people that learn to bless the Lord at all times. When he says, I want out of the marriage, bless the Lord. If he bring you flowers, bless the Lord. If she don't cook, bless the Lord. Pain in your body, Lord, I thank you. I can feel it. In all things, I will bless the Lord at all times. David says his praise will continually be in my mouth because I don't know where the devil is. I don't know which door he's trying to come in. I don't know all of his tricks and his cunning, but I'm going to bless the Lord at all times. His praise shall continually be in my mouth. David wrote this too. David said, if people give thanks unto the Lord. Oh, if we would just give thanks unto the Lord. He says, magnify the Lord with me. Now the preacher talking. Oh, don't let me magnify and lift up all by myself. Oh, I'm not the only one that he woke up this morning. I'm not the only one that he started on my way. Oh, let us exalt the Lord together. He says, I sought the Lord. This was me about 23 years ago. I was going to church, I wasn't seeking the Lord. I was an usher, but I wasn't seeking the Lord. I was singing in the youth choir, but I wasn't looking for God. I was just doing my church duties. But about 23 years ago, I began to look for him. I began to realize that I was a sinner that needed a Savior. And I sought the Lord. And he heard my cry. And he attended my cry, and it delivered me out of the muck in the miry pit. This poor man cried out, and the Lord heard him and saved him from all of my troubles. I can't tell you about all my troubles. Give me a teacher moment. At 8 a.m. service here earlier this morning, gentleman was here that's going through chemotherapy. I shared this with the Sunday school class. He's going through chemotherapy. And after 8 a.m. service, I found him for the first time over in the kitchen eating. Usually, you know, he goes home after 8 a.m. But on today, he was eating in the kitchen. I said, bro, excuse me. I said, what you doing here? I said, I've never seen you eat. He said, Pastor, because I couldn't eat. He says, I can swallow now. He said, I just want to give God thanks that I can swallow this little bit of food. See, some of us take for granted that we can chew our food, or we can swallow our food. Some people take it for granted that they can put one foot in front of the other. But some of us had to roll in here. Some of us had to be pushed in here. Some of us had to be carried in here. But somebody ought to bless the Lord. Oh, my soul. And all. Bless his holy name. Bless his holy name. And then he says, oh, taste and see that the Lord is good. In other words, if you ain't tried him, you can't tell me about him. You ought to taste and see that the Lord is good. I'll stop y'all trying to make me preach. Get through this. Let me get through this. Ain't it a shame to get all dressed up in your Gucci, all dressed up in your Tommy gear, and all dressed up in your Saks Fifth Avenue gear that Glenn Johnson got on. Wouldn't it be a shame to be all dressed up, just shining, and come in here and you don't even taste and see? As good as y'all looking, you might as well taste and see that the Lord is good and his mercies endure forever. I'm almost done. Let me get through this. See, I used to come here. I used to go to my home church every Sunday, but I wasn't trying to taste it. I was trying to do my duties. I was trying to work my way into glory. Is there anybody here that feel that you're going to get in because you give a look, a piece of chain, because you sing in the choir, because you usher? I ain't smiled yet. But you usher. I mean, you on the board, you on the committee, and we feel that we're going to get in. But if you ever taste, you're going to see some. See, if you taste it, you'll see some. Let me touch my buddy Daryl right here. See, some of us see too much. But see, if some of us were blinded, we might begin to taste and see that the Lord was good. See, y'all together. See, watch this. See, some of us are saved because we found ourselves going through hell. But if it had not been for the Lord that was on my side, where would I be? Get out of here. Let me get out of here. David continues to write. He says, when I consider the heavens, the moon, and the stars, all that you've created, what man that you're mindful of him? He says, when I look at all that you've created, these galaxies, the Milky Ways, and the vastness that you've created, what is it about man? You know, you've given him dominion. We're back at the dominion piece. You've given him dominion. You've given mankind dominion. You've given mankind authority. You've given mankind the opportunity to subdue and to rule in the earth of all people, not the Leviathan, not the whale, not the hippopotamus or the elephant, not the lions, the tigers, or the bears, but man. Ungrateful, unkind, inconsiderate, faithless man. Can't count on him. Got his own mind. Sometimes he won't speak. And you left him in charge of what you made. Look, watch. I heard this last week.
the same dirt that you made gonna hang your son on the cross, and you gave him dominion. What is it about this man with his money in the bank? What is it about man, tall, dark, and handsome? What is it about man? She's 38, 26, 38. A brick house. What is it about man? I'm still trying to figure this out. Watch, because I'm thinking about me now. What is it about Tracy Bell? Senior pastor? Oh, my. What is it about some of us that God left us dominion? In spite of what we used to do, he says, I want you to sing in the choir. In spite of what we used to do, he says, I'm going to ordain you as a deacon. In spite of what we used to do, he says, look, I know you ain't tithing. Come on, I'll make you a trustee. Come on, come on, come on. You know what I'm saying? He takes my unrighteousness and impart his righteousness. He takes my unfaithfulness and impart his faithfulness. He takes my his righteousness. He takes my sin and gave me his love. What is it about this man that you are mindful of him? And you put everything that you've made under his feet. I'm in charge of what you've made. And just as he started, he ends with, oh Lord, our Lord, how excellent is your name in all of the earth. God, you know, no matter where I look, God, I see the fingerprints of your hands. No matter where I go, God, I see your glory. And all I can really say is, oh, Mary, when we go to the mall, my wife, she's a touchy feeling person. I'm like, oh, girl, ain't all that. Mary, she's like, you know, she says something. She sees, she's like, ooh, would you look at that? I'm like, mm-hmm. And then she'd be like, ooh, Snooky, feel that. And I'm like, mm-hmm. You know, when my wife eats something, she's like, this is good. I'm like, girl, you swallow the food. But, you know, you see, she's expressive. You know, I believe we serve a God that wants someone to express the love for him. I believe we serve a God that wants someone to recognize what he's done in their life. I wish there was just two or three that would say, oh, Lord, our Lord, how excellent is your name in all the earth. I didn't earn it. I don't deserve it. But God, you did it anyway. I don't even deserve the house that I live in. I don't deserve the car that I'm driving. The children you gave me, I couldn't have done it without you, God. Oh, Lord, our Lord, how excellent is your name. Somebody stand on their feet with me. Come on, let's give God praise for his excellence, for his glory, for his loving kindness, for his majesty. Oh, Lord, our Lord, how excellent is your name. And all that, please stand with me, ministers. I don't know what else to say. Now it's up to someone to taste and see that the Lord is good. Watch this. You don't even have to be a senior citizen and see that the Lord is good. You don't even have to be going through chemotherapy. You don't have to be going through a bad marriage. You don't have to be going through anything. All you have to do is taste and see that he's good. I'm telling you, he's good. I'm telling you, he's good. And he has a check in the mail for someone that's in need. Perhaps you already know him as your Lord and Savior. They say even a child will understand that. You don't have to be, oh, come in, miracle. This is my little miracle. You want to give your life to Christ? You know what Jesus did for you? Did he die for you? Yes, he died for you. See, even a child can understand it. How old are you, miracle? He's 7 years old. Some of us 27, 37, 57, 77, and we're still waiting on I don't know what. But if you would come and humble yourself as a little child. Quieter. Maybe you already know him as Lord of Lords and King of Kings, but you're looking for a church covering. You're looking for a watch care place, a place that you can call home. As a matter of fact, you don't join New Bethel. We want you to join the body of Christ. Amen, ministers. We just want you to be part of the household of faith. It doesn't have to be this household of faith. Maybe you're in a backsliding state. My Bible says you're married to the backslider. As a matter of fact, you can slide back as far as you want. God said, I'm not going anywhere. As a matter of fact, you can slide down this red carpet today, just as you are. I know it's a little crowded in here, but if you just say, excuse me, let you out, they'll let you out. Come on, I'm help you push through the fear. I'm going to help you push past the pain. Just say, excuse me, excuse me, excuse me. Look at my brother right there. Just say, excuse me, excuse me. I just need to get back with God. I just need to get in the right. This is my brother. This is my old classmate. God bless you, man. I love you, man. God bless you. God bless you. God bless you. I went to school with this brother. Talk to him and see what he needs. See, he got it. He just tasted and seen that the Lord is good. Look, just because you don't feel chill bumps means absolutely nothing. It's a faith thing. And all he wants you to do is to put your faith in what he did on Calvary. Look, look, he knows you still smoking something, drinking something. That's why he came. That's why he came. Watch. He didn't come because you're righteous. Can I stand right here? He didn't come because you're righteous. He came because you are unrighteous. Look, I don't care what member of a church you are. If you're not part of the body of Christ, and if you happen to die today, oops. There's no second chance. Tell the person that's standing beside you, excuse me, let me out. I got to go get this. I may not be promised. I went to a funeral last week. The child was 16. The week before that, the child was 8. How old are you? You better come. We're going to give you about 30 seconds. Come on, come on, come on, come on. Put your hands together for somebody that's about to come. Come on, come on, come on. We'll ruin you all. Come on. Come, 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 come. Sing it out. Sing, sing, sing. Come on, let's sing it. How excellent.
How excellent.
Oh, his name is excellent. There's no flaws in his name. Yes. How excellent.
How excellent.
My. God bless you. You may have your seats if you can. Sing, choir. There's none like you. Come on, y'all help him sing it. None like you. His name is excellent. Amen. Put your hands together for our youth. Amen. To God be the glory. Let me say this. Just in case there were too many people that were looking, give me something. At you. You can still get with me and one of the ministers or one of the deacons at the end of service. We take salvation so serious here. We're not trying to preach somebody happy. We really want you to know Jesus as your personal Lord and Savior. And that's why we pay the bills. That's why we do what we do. Keep the church clean. We're increasing our parking. It's all about making sure that you have a place that you can come and worship the Lord in spirit and in truth. If you don't know him, hook up with one of the ministers of the gospel. Hook up with one of the deacons. Hook up with someone and say, would you pray for me? I was so afraid to come up. But if you can touch on me and just take me through the sinner's prayer that I'm a sinner that needs a Savior, I won't miss out on heaven. Amen. Someone that's watching us by way of live stream on today, we invite you to trust him as your personal Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. And all you have to do is to say, Lord, I'm a sinner. and I need a Savior. I've come short of your glory like everyone else. Lord, I need you to have mercy on me. For I've went every which way but to the right way. Perhaps you may even go to church, but say, God, I need you to forgive me for all of my sins. And then say this, say, God, I believe that you've heard me, and I believe that you have forgiven me. And I thank you, Lord, for receiving me as your child, just as I am. Thank you, God, for saving me, in Jesus' name. And if you said that prayer, if you repeated it after me with your mouth, and if you believed in your heart, we believe that you're saved. Bless the Lord that you're saved now. You're born again now. You don't have to come to New Bethel, but find you a place that you can go and worship the Lord in spirit and in truth. Give us a call, and we'll hook up with you. If you're not comfortable with any other church, you can call New Bethel your home for the meanwhile. To God be the glory for the great thing that he has done. Hear the church say, amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. It's giving time. It's giving time. It's giving time. Oh, somebody want to say thank you. I got something to give. Amen. Come on. I got a little something to give. They made a whole lot this month, this week. But God, I thank you. I got a little something to give. Those that are watching us by way of live streaming, also there's a donate button. Please consider a sowing in this household of faith. This is good soil. So much we do here with the food pantry and so much more that we do to help people that are standing in need. So we encourage not only those that are watching us by live stream, we also encourage those of you that's right here. Don't stop at the 10%. Don't forget the offering as well. A tithe and an offering, because God has done so much for us. What shall I render unto the Lord for all that he has done for me? To God be the glory for the great things that he has done. I believe the, and this is the sorority, 30 years? Is this 30 years? Y'all give me a hand. Look, here's the good thing. They saved, y'all. All the ones I personally know, they saved. Amen. And they do so much in the community. I've seen them. They do angel trees. They do Thanksgiving boxes. And they do things for the upbuilding of the kingdom of God. So we salute you for all that you've done. As a matter of fact, I think they got something for New Bethel on today. President Gwendolyn Ruffin Johnson, come on up here. Come on over. You got a presentation? Come on. Y'all give her a hand as you come down the runway, down the red carpet. You come on up. I want to see these rhinestones here, or them diamonds. Come on here. I'll tell out a little bit on you. This is my first cousin. My mama, her mama was sisters. You know I was going to embarrass you. Give me some sound. There we go.
Good morning. On behalf of Beta Lambda Sigma Follows of Sigma Gamma Rho Sorority, we are celebrating our Founders Day today, and we would like to make this small donation to New Bethel for the upbuilding of their kingdom.
Amen. She said she's going to get me, Ms. Wall. Amen. We do again thank Ms. Forty for leaving your prospective home churches. I know it was hard for y'all to leave Poplar Springs and Maple Temple, St. Amanda, might have said, St. Matthew, Juniper Level. You know where you go. We just calling out names. Christian Faith, amen. We thank God for each and every one of you. And because you've sown into this ministry, we pray that God will give it back to you 100-fold. For the upbuilding of his kingdom and all that you're doing as unto the Lord. Let's just say amen. Let us stand together. The trustees and the ushers will come. Amen. Immediately.
Amen.
Following that, we're going to recognize all of our guests as well and recognize birthdays as well.
Amen.
And Reverend, if you have a youth meditation, want to do that as well today. Amen. It's early. It's just 12 o'clock. Amen. Y'all come dropping now. Y'all come smiling now. All right now.